Joanne.
Hello.
How are you feeling?
I'm all right, thank you.
Good. Well, we've done the markings, and that's the most important part of the surgery in terms of planning what we're going to do. So the next step is really just take you down to the operating room and make some nice new breasts for you.
Okay.
Any questions?
No.
Okay.
You just planned everything.
Good. I think we're all set in that case.
Okay, lovely.
I'll see you down there.
All right. Thank you.
Again. The reason we're doing this surgery is that she's had loss of support of her breasts as a result of her pregnancy. What we're going to do today is we're not only going to correct the loss of volume that she's had, but we're also going to tighten the skin up. And we're going to do that by doing what's called a periareola mastopexy. We're going to take the skin out around the areola, and we're going to tighten the breast up. No amount of exercise would help to lift these breasts. And so really, this is the only solution to lifting the breasts. We're just injecting the local anesthetic under the muscle now. And this will just cut down on our bleeding during surgery. What we're doing here is we're just making the areola into a perfect circle. And the areola is a pigmented skin around a nipple. And now we're taking out the skin around the areola. It's like skinning the patient. This is a procedure that we do quite a lot on the breast and then allows us to reshape the breast. So now we're just going to make a little pocket under the muscle, the pectoralis major muscle. And the muscle then gives a nice smooth cover to the implant, makes it look very natural. It's one of the reasons why we really prefer to put implants behind the muscle rather than in front. It's a more painful operation, and so people often opt to put it in front. But when it's in front, it has more of that Baywatch look. This is just an expander or a sizer that we just inflate temporarily with air. And it just gives us an idea of the shape of the breast. And then we'll put the permanent implant in afterwards. Can you count these pieces for us? It's number one going in.
One.
Number two going in. This is a silicone gel implant. I think silicone is one of the most inert substances known to man. It's been around now almost 40 years. There's been a tremendous amount of research into it. And they just feel like breasts, and they look like breasts. The best candidate for this kind of procedure is the person whose breast has sagged so that the nipple has reached the level of the crease beneath the breast, or maybe just about half an inch below it. If it's fallen more than that, then they probably need a standard mastopexy with the T-shaped scars. This is called a purse string suture. It's a cinching suture that we use to bring the areola skin together, and you're going to see that in a moment. This is a permanent stitch, stays there forever. This just controls the size of that we're pulling it down. You just don't get a good idea of how the implant in the breast looks unless you sit the patient up. As you can see, the breast now is nice and round. It's soft and natural in appearance, and you have the areola and the nipple are in the middle of the breast instead of being down, which is what happens when you breastfeed and you have children and the nipple drops. And so we've brought this breast back to a pre-pregnancy position. So you can see here's the final closure scar, and we've got a nice thin line, and that's going to be a nice thin scar. The tension is taken off by that purse string suture that we put in. The patient is bandaged. We're going to move her to recovery room. She's probably going to have a little pain. I put long-acting local anesthetic. I injected it on both sides. So that's going to help. And we'll give her pain medication if she needs it.
Very groggy, sleepy. I've had a lot of tablets. And a little bit sore. And very thirsty.
Joanne, congratulations, you've passed your audition for the Hammer House of Horrors. That was, you couldn't look, could you?
No,
neither could I.
It's such a delicate part of the body. I suppose it's a bit like watching a man have an operation sort of down there.
Yeah.
You kind of wince and everything. Anyway, 3.5 months on, 2.5 months on, how is it?
Oh, fine.
Painless?
Yes, absolutely.
Do they feel normal to you?
Firm.
Firm?
Yeah. They are firm.
But you said...
But that's the object.
Yeah. And they, you said 4 days after that you're out shopping.
Exactly.
No problems at all. And the main benefit is there's so little scarring.
Yeah. There's Virtually none.
Yeah.
I would say in 6 months' time there'll be no sparring at all.
Well, would you care to stand up and assume the position that I think we rehearsed earlier? And we'll just see the real difference now, the before and the after. So, obviously that's, you know, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
It's made a huge difference. Has it changed your view of yourself and your confidence?
Yes. Yes. Yeah,
you were saying earlier, it's the kind of surgery you'd actually have again if you needed it.
It wasn't that bad.
Yeah.
It wasn't that bad, no. Not at all.
Honestly, who'd be a surgeon there?
Well, you know, it's a drink to them, isn't it?
A surgeon.
I know. I mean, obviously they cut all the way around the nipple there. What about sensation? Is that fine?
Yes.
There's no nerve damage
No, there's no nerve damage, but they can't guarantee that.
Ah, that is a slight risk, isn't
it? Yes.
But in your case, it's okay.
Yes, yeah. It's fine.
Excellent. Well, thank you. Thanks for coming in.
Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thanks for not watching.
Oh, I know. I couldn't watch it.
And if you want details of the operations in all the series, all the